and welcome to You Talking to Me. After 3 years of existence, the European Citizens Initiative seems to have failed. It gives the right to the European citizen to take part into the European Union legislations, and this is not working properly and reforms need to be done. And to debate on this, I have the pleasure to welcome my three guests. So I have Marlène Mizzi, you a Socialist and Democrats member in the European Parliament, and you also working on the revision of the ECI, so we will say ECI, European Citizen Initiative, in the European Parliament. Hello.
Hello. Hi. Thank you very much for having me over for this very interesting subject. Yes, I am the Shadow Rapporteur for SND.
Okay, thank you. It's a pleasure to welcome you. And Mr. Stanislas Jourdan, you're working at ECI Campaign. You're a coordinator at this organization.
Yeah, exactly. This is an NGO that promotes the improvement of DCI. And I was personally myself an organizer of one of the initiatives on basic income.
Okay, and we will also be joined, we also joined by Magdalena, who is a journalist from Polska Radio, or Euronet Plus Network member.
Hello, thanks for having me.
Hello, Magda. So after 3 years, the European Commission has evaluated the function of the European Citizens Initiative, and the result is not that good. Out of 551 initiatives, only one reached the final process and had a positive answers from the European Commission. It is Right to Water, which gives access to clean water for all Europeans. So, Mr. Jourdan, do you think this right is under threat?
Yeah, absolutely, because as you said, only a few ECIs have successfully got to the final stage after getting 1 million signatures, but also a lot of ECIs were just not even registered by the Commission because of reason that the Commission considered that they fall manifestly outside of its competencies. But we also know that in terms of competence, it's a grey area, and the Commission is using a very narrow interpretation of what kind of ECI it could register. So we really believe that it's not been implemented well enough. Mm-hmm. And also there are lots of technical problems for organizers in terms of organizing a campaign.
So and in 3 years also, 6 million only citizens out of the 500 million Europeans signed the initiative. So this is a failure to reach European citizens. Mrs. Mizzi.
You are correct. I think that there's not enough information. I think the system that has been utilized up till now is very cumbersome. So it is not easy to use. And this is not a technocrat's initiative. This is a citizen's initiative. And so the citizens must be able to be informed as much as possible about its uses. Otherwise, it is useless. It is the voice which is technically given to the citizen to speak and to influence legislation in Parliament. But if it's so difficult to do so, then we are really, really spoiling the idea. And it is such a good idea. But there are so many problems. Yeah, it is so cumbersome.
So many, among the problems, it remains really technical and legal problems.
Absolutely. And expense. When we're talking of the requirements of seven different countries taking part and seven different members starting this organization, you have a lot of problems. You have translation problems, just to say something mm-hmm. which is obvious. You need legal advice. You need administrative support. You need financial support, and that is not forthcoming.
Mm-hmm. And also, we will come back on the main problems that is happening now with this ECI initiative. So, Magda, you have a question about rejected initiatives.
Because, out of three initiatives that collected more than 1 million signatures, there was one that was actually rejected by the European Commission, even despite the collection of, I think, almost 2 million signatures. It's of course about One of Us, so it's an initiative that had the aim to and financing of activities that are about destruction of human embryos, in particular in public health development and research. I would like to know your opinion on that. Despite the collection of so many European signatures, still the European Commission said that it was actually, there was no room for improvement. The European law is okay as it is. So basically ignored what the European citizens wanted.
Mr. Jourdan, maybe you can
What we demand at the ECI campaign is that every ECI that get 1 million signatures should lead to a legislative process. So the Commission should draft a legislation or do something. If it's not a legislation, it could be other things that she does in terms of having studies and so on. But it should go into the whole procedure of legislation. And then, of course, it may not be adopted and nothing may happen. But at least let the debate happen among the EU institutions.
You also think the same?
I think it's not only the this particular ECI which was rejected for reasons also because they did not want to impinge on national legislations. But even if you take the right for water, it's 1.8 million and it was accepted, it was considered. But what has happened? There was no legislative proposal as far as this is concerned. So it was considered, it was admissible, it was dealt with. But in the end, what do we have? We have nothing. So even 1.8 million admissible citizens were completely ignored, or they were only technically considered. Mm-mm. So that is not really acceptable.
Yeah. And even when initiative succeeded as a right to water, I mean, it doesn't lead directly, automatically to a draft law.
Exactly.
So that's a bit taking the citizen for fool.
Yes, it is the ECI has succeeded. It is the Commission who has not delivered. So really, we are telling this citizen, look, you have this tool. It is a very good tool so that you can propose legislation which interests you. But then the tool, they're not telling the citizen how to use this tool. And even if the citizens use this tool, it's being ignored. So yes, there's a lot to be done, and I don't think that ECI should be ignored. I think we should really push that this is going to be a real tool for the citizen. We don't want to take the citizens for a ride.
Thank you. And we have now a question from Lydia from Radio TV Slovenia. She's a member of UNET Plus Network. Hello, Lydia.
Hi, everyone.
Send Lydia to your question for our guest. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, of course. As we know, the three-year review report has underlined that there is still much room for improvement for the initiative in order to live up to its full potential. Plus, the European Commission, as you said it yourself, has also admitted that the initiative needs urgent reform. How do you intend to do that, and what concrete changes can we expect to make sure the initiative makes it to its fourth birthday? Thank you.
Maybe Mrs. Mitzi, you can answer from that.
I think that's a brilliant question, really. It's true, there's a lot to be done, and it's up to us. For example, I'm a vice president of the Petitions Committee, and I'm shadowing this report. And obviously, we do have suggestions, but it will take...
For example, what are they?
Okay, so we need to support the citizen in real terms. Financially, administratively, we need to reduce bureaucracy. We need to have a one-stop shop so that the citizens will not have to go around like chickens without a head, not knowing how to go about this. And we need actual support. So basically, it's administrative and financial support, because this is really a very expensive exercise, especially when you're dealing internationally, when there's differences in cultures, differences in languages. There's the need for legal support. So basically, what we need is making it easier, make it accessible, financial support, administrative support. Of course, these are just the headlines. And there we will cascade them down to details.
We will now have a look at our reaction on Facebook. We have one from the Union of European Federalists. They failed to launch an ECI in 2011 called the New Deal for Europe. And this was made to respond to the economic crisis, but it has failed. And so they wrote a comment and they say it's very difficult to have the agreement of the Commission to launch an ECI, as we discussed. It is too long and too complicated. The website of the ECI is not user-friendly enough, and the delay is too short to collect all the signatures within the 28 national public spaces. So, Mr. Jourdan, you also pointed out all these problems. Could you explain us what are the main problems and barriers today?
The main problems are technical and political. There are two problems. The technical problem is like for organizer, you don't really decide when the campaign starts, and then you have 12 months to collect the signatures, so it's the countdown start, but you don't really control when you push the button. The commission does instead. So that's a big problem because campaigners cannot properly organize the launch of the campaign. There are also the online collection system, the software that that organizers have to use to collect signatures. It's a very secure software, but it's also very not user-friendly because, for example, as organizer, we cannot collect the emails of the people who support our campaign, which is very very annoying because we want to update them and allow them to take part in our movement. And also one other problem, which is a problem of the member states, not necessarily the Commission or the EU, but is the problem that in many countries you need to sign with an ID number or passport number. And we, from 3 years of experience, we can tell that it really many people don't want to sign because of this.
Mm-hmm. And there is also a lack of advertising on this. I mean, many people doesn't know even if this tool exists.
Exactly. Yes, but also the lack of advertising also comes because the ECI is not politically strong enough, because the only few ECIs have succeeded to get the million because of all the technical problems, and at the end the commission does nothing. So we would get more promotion of the ECIs if we get strong, interesting ECIs that do breakthrough in the EU process of legislating.
Mm. So now the European Commission has published its report and say, no, we have done our job. No, it's up to the European Parliament to come with some proposals. What are your most urgent reform proposals?
Well, as I said, yes, that is one way of actually throwing the ball in our court. And it is, but there are a number of proposals, and they all surround the fact that the citizen must be informed, the citizen must be supported, the citizen must be given all the tools to actually make use of this initiative. Otherwise, it's going to be useless. There's a long list. I mentioned them before. I don't want to repeat. But we want to ensure that this is the citizen who benefits from this, and not making it easier for the Commission. The Commission has to deliver.
Mm-hmm. Okay, thank you very much, all of you, for coming. And thank you for following us. And see you next time. Bye.